as usual. And that's because I want to make a very old, let's call it town, a touristic, more or less touristic town. It's like something that it was here long, long time ago before. Since I wanted to start the series, before I started the series, this is how I saw the things, doing some builds from time to time, doing some stories and so on. But I will try to do more stories because I really do know that you guys enjoy the stories. I really do also enjoy the stories. I really do enjoy. Cinematics. I do not. I intend to make a story after I finish this little town. Let's keep calling it a town. It's a town that it was more inspired from Cinque. Our area is a national area there. It's absolutely impressive and amazing. I don't know the history behind this Cinque Terre area, but it is impressive because you see there, you can find there lots of colorful buildings and lots of gardens, orchards, and on the hillside, very, very tight, and lots of stairs, lots of steep areas, rocks, and you should for those who are not from Europe at least and don't know what I'm talking about, you should really try to search for Cinque Terre, because it's impressive. You'll really love it, especially if you're going to find some nice wallpapers or pictures from there. It is totally impressive. So I'm not going to copy that. I'm just trying to inspire, even though I did something similar in Osaka, like a village on a hill with houses that are very close to each other, above each other buildings, and also on a hill, like the favelas from Brazil. This is a totally different thing. The main idea of having some buildings on a steep hill or a steep little mountain, maybe that's only the only thing that is similar to that, to what I did in Osaka as well. But this is it's a touristic area, it's a touristic city town, not a city, a town, a beautiful place where people live and turn, you know, like in Greece, like in some areas in Greece, you know, you see these colorful buildings. It's really something wow. It really is wow. So that's what I've tried to do. And I don't want to say too much about what this will be and how everything will turn up into, because I will prefer to let Johan to tell more, to tell you the history, not the history, the story. Well, the history as well, because there will be a history behind it. But as a main thing, this is what I've tried to achieve here. To make a town, a beautiful touristic town with some colorful houses. With some, I try to detail it not that much, but as much as I could, in order to make it look full of life and full of vegetation and colors, of course, because colors are the main thing here. Also, now that I'm building here and showing you the entire time lapse, and also because there is no story, I prefer to tell you. What I intend to do in the future and what are my plans for Arndorf, because if there are some really, and I know there are people, me especially, I'm a big fan of Arndorf. I know it's my series, but I'm a big fan because it's something that I wanted to do since I started my channel a long time ago, but not that long time ago, but it is some time. This is what I intended then, to do a little story, a town with or a city with a story. Well, here I am 1 year later, maybe doing that, trying to do so. And what are you going to see in the future? That's what I also did here, a build in advance. Also, in the next episode, again, I'm repeating myself, but I really want to make sure you guys understand it. In the next video, you will also see a time-lapse build with only few cinematics. Because I do not want to spoil to make a big spoiler about a video and what you're going to see. If you're interested, you'll watch it. But everything you want to see, lots and lots and lots of cinematics, you'll be seeing them during the story of told by Johan. So this is episode 6. In episode 7, you'll also see a continue of this build that I'm doing today, and then we will I will just do a story video about 10 minutes or more, told by, of course, our beloved Johan. So for those who are interested in this, please just watch and listen to my own story now about our Arndorf. And what I intended to do for this series is that in the future I prefer to advance a little bit faster with my builds, because I want to tell stories but also to bring some new things to the city. For example, maybe 10 or 20 or 30 years passed and the new mayor or someone else or God knows what will happen, because I will try to not tell you exactly, just the main idea. There will be some things that would be changed in Arndorf and the region, and you guys will also help me out with some things. You'll be the voice of the people, so you'll be able to vote and help me out, and not help me out but also develop Arndorf. So you'll be one of the most important pawns there to develop Arndorf with me here. By voting, but everything it's, let's say, in place for a specific moment when everything will happen, and of course with a reason, so you have to be there and wait for it. And because also I have some surprises for you, hopefully they will be a surprise. And yeah, this is the main thing. But in order for me to do that, and in order for me to achieve my goals about Arndorf, I need to advance a little bit faster in the game. And doing the videos as I did before with the stories and with the cinematics that are crossfading between each other, it takes quite a lot of time. And if I would have done that in every single episode, I think now you won't be able to see episode 6, maybe episode 4 or 3. I don't know. It takes time. Even though I know, maybe quality before quantity, because that's what I intend to do. But after all, there will be no fun for me if I'm going to do only that type of videos. The fun of doing it will be lost pretty fast, and then, well, that would be even worse than I intend to do. So I prefer to also do some time-lapse video to advance faster in order to bring other type of ideas and stories in for you guys here. Plus, as I told you, you know, imagine, for example, these stairs that you are seeing, you just saw me built there. Imagine that I will tell you the story from Johan's perspective, of course, and telling me that the mayor or the stairs there that were old more than 70 years collapsed, and people will have to cannot go down there, they have to make a detour, or maybe I will invent something like the mayor of this area will of Arndorf will build new stairs, intend to add an elevator and to make it more modern, or to recondition these stairs, and blah 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 blah, stuff like this. And trust me, this will be way much interesting. This is what I intend from the beginning. This is what I had into my mind before. So I will try to do that. But again, to do these kind of things, I need time to build. And guys, you really do understand. I want to tell you more about the builds I'm doing right now, because they are pretty interesting, at least in my head here. But maybe they are better told by Johan. They should be better told by Johan. The main idea of what I make the why am I blabbering? The main idea of what I did here is to make, again, a touristic little town. There will be some beaches. Beaches? Oh my god, I always have issue telling this word. There will be some, it's a big beach there at the bottom of this little town. So there'll be a nice touristic area there for people to come and take a bath into the water. Well, they will actually don't, because people cannot do that in this game, which actually this would be a very good DLC in the future for Paradox. They should do a touristic DLC to have some people that can take a bath in the sea, you know, and more ideas for the seaside. That would be really interesting, because if I'm going to hit some park generators into the water, people will be dressed up, so it's kind of not that realistic, if you know what I mean. There is a bridge. I wanted to make more bridges. If you look into Chiquetel, you'll see so many tunnels for streets, for trains, many nice Belvedere view, many dangerous places, I might say, because when you live very close to the cliffs and very close to the water, it is kind of dangerous, and you know, I think, I'm not sure if you can fall from there, but I think I'm gonna find out in the future, because me and my girlfriend intend to visit Chiquetel in sometimes at a point. We had this in plan for quite a time now, and we will get there, we will get there for sure. But I think that would be one interesting thing as soon as I get there. I can't say I will see something that I try to do here, because I'm not coping that area. Maybe I should have, but for those who even though I think it's quite hard to do this, I looked it on the Google Maps, and not only, and it's not easy at all. It really is not easy. So that would be a very big challenge for someone to try to do. Let's not say exactly at scale, but to try to reproduce that area. I mean, it is very, very hard. Not impossible, but extremely hard, actually. Not very hard, extremely hard. And that's because the game Cities: Skylines is quite limited in some circumstances. Plus the terrain, the way the terrain works, it has its own physics. It's also the water, so I don't think it is possible. Plus we have some things that are not very well scaled here, and that's another issue. But it would be really, that would be really a great thing to do. I mean, this can be an entire project for someone. I mean, imagine doing this, it will take months, really. I'm not lying, you can do this in few weeks or months to redo the Cinque Terre area. Because it's very hard, and also again, it's not easy to reproduce it in Cities: Skylines. Of course, if you want to try to do it as much as you can, similar to what is there. Okay, so what else can I tell you about my current build here before we say goodbyes, even though we still have some like 10 minutes or less until the time lapse ends. But I'll try to make a little... So there will be two kind of towns here. Well, it's one town, but two parts of the town, two sides of the town. This first part that you are going, that you are watching right now, it's the touristic one, the one that was not renovated, but it is like a build in order for tourists, and not only. And there will be another build, the one that would be very close to the seaside, very close to the beaches, and that one, it will be the main town, the main side of the town. I'll try to make some crazy roads, crazy intersections, crazy junctions, and so on. And I'm hoping, even though it is difficult, I'll try my very, very best to finish this next build until Sunday, because it's very hard to respect my schedule for Arndorf. I'm trying to respect it as much as I can, which is impossible again. And that's because the way I'm doing the videos. And I really want to try to improve my quality and not to just have some videos there. So that's another reason why I'm late with the videos of Arndorf. And another reason why you guys see me doing some custom build videos, which are different, of course, it's because I try to take a break from Arndorf and from the entire idea and do something else. This keeps me on a better, let's say, on a better feeling, you know. I'm doing something else. Plus Kingdom Come Deliverance, also a game, a series that I really do enjoy. It's also here because I want to break just a little bit the routine of doing one single thing over and over again. Yeah, this is now I'm doing the side where the lighthouse is, because we need a lighthouse here as well. A very old lighthouse. It doesn't look old at all. There will be some houses near it in order for people that lived there before, something like a long time ago. But you will hear a story for that as well. I'm really looking forward to continue this build. I'm really looking forward to tell you the story from Johan's perspective. I know you guys, some of you like to hear Johan's voice as well, not only the text. But there are some few people that told me that you guys enjoy more just to read and not to hear someone speaking. Well, I think more people are saying that prefer to hear Johan, and also me. I prefer to hear Johan as well. It is easier. It's easier, and plus our Joachim, the guy that narrates through Johan's voice, it's really nice, because his voice is he has an accent, a German accent, which is really beautiful because again Johann lives somewhere near Germany. It's not in Germany, it's a different country. Maybe we should not even tell the name of the country. I think it's enough. It's okay as it is. So it's a country led by a king. So it's a regency here still, like there is in, if I'm not mistaken, in Norway, yeah, in Sweden and also in, UK as well. But that's what I intend. Of course, here there will be a little old palace that now it's just a museum for people to visit. That's why I'm doing here some parking areas at the bottom of the palace. I'll do again some stairs that will lead up to the palace and so on. But if you want to see and hear more, well, don't forget to join me next time, guys, in the next video where I will continue my build. So again, no stories, but hopefully, guys, I will see you there as well, because I really do hope you are not here just to hear Johann. You are here to see the entire build. And in the 8th episode, Johann will come with the story. So more likely the next video will be up on Sunday, because it's just a time-lapse build and I might be able to finish it. Plus I intend to do some other kind of videos right now for City Skylines. I'll try to come with some funny type videos. When I started my channel 1 year ago, first 10 videos, it was there were two funny videos, well, funny from my point of view at least. Some of you guys enjoyed it, the ones that were there on my channel at the beginning. I really did enjoy that video, some not, but I stopped doing that. And I will really be glad to come back and do some funny videos as well, which I'm sure that you guys will enjoy it. So yeah, this is what I intend to do. Wednesday, Osaka will be up again on my channel with another video, so another episode of Osaka, and then some funny videos, and then at the end of the week you guys are going to see the next episode of Arnlov. So I think this week you are about to see, with this one, 4 different videos, I guess. Yeah, I think 4 videos. Well, fingers crossed. I don't want to jinx it, but I hope I really will be able to do so. Anyways, guys, we are very close to the end of the time lapse here. Hope you did enjoy this. Don't forget to hit the like button, leave some comments, tell me what you think about this build. And guys, of course, if you are new here, don't forget to check the entire playlist of this series. Go from the first episode, from the intro episode, to listen the stories, so you know what exactly you are watching and how things are going here. And we will see each other hopefully this Sunday, guys. Wish you an entire great week, and of course, I salute you.